Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the workshop on control theory and partial differential equation. It's a pleasure for me to open this morning session on Tuesday, 25th of May. The chairman of the session will be Professor Fagner Alarunen. You can start, Fagner.
It's a pleasure for me to introduce Francisco Guillén González. Francisco Guillén González is a full professor at the Universidad de Sevilla and possess, according to MedSciNet Mathematical Reviews, more than 913 citations in about 110 published papers. Professor Guillén González will present this lecture, whose title is Optimal Control for Summer Chemotax PDEs Models. Francisco, the word is yours.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Juan, thank you, Fagner. Thank you for the introduction. It's a pleasure for me to speak in this session and to take the opportunity to give some of the results about the researches of our research group. In fact, the talk will be about the optimal control for some chemotaxis PD model. Then I will explain a little about the chemotaxis PD model, which is the more important effect considering in this problem, in this nonlinear parabolic systems. And after that, we will give some optimal control result related to some of these chemotaxis PDs. This result that we will present here is obtained in collaboration with some of my collaborator, Maria Ángeles Rodríguez Bellido from Sevilla, Ezequiel Matías Cepeda from Chile, Universidad Tarapacá, and also from Eldel Villamizar Roa from Colombia, Universidad Industrial de Santander. And the plan is the following. First of all, we will speak about chemotaxis PD model, two types of chemotaxis PD model. The first one is the chemotaxion production problem, and the second one, the chemorepulsion production problem. I will explain later a little about this difference between these two types of problem. And after that, we present an optimal control problem. We will explain the complete results of this optimal control problem for one case, for the case when P equal one will be the linear, the case of linear production term. And after some difference in the nonlinear production case, it will be for a parameter P between one and two. And finally, some conclusions, work in progress, and references. Then, first of all, which is the chemotaxis phenomenon? The chemotaxis phenomenon is a biological process of the movement of living organisms in response to a chemical stimulus. This stimulus could be attractive from toward a higher concentration of a chemical substance, or can be repulsive. For instance, in this case is the attractive case when yellow is the chemical concentration, then living organisms go to the higher chemical concentration, and in the repulsive case, living organisms go towards a lower concentration chemical. Yeah, this is the effect. And the paradigmatic problem in this context is a problem called the Killer-Segel problem. And in this problem, there are two parabolic problems. One problem for U, the cell density, the density of the living organism, and for V, the chemical concentrations signal in order to reproduce the chemotaxis effect. And for The more complicated equation is the equation for the cell density, because this equation has the cell diffusion effect, but also have the chemotaxis term. The chemotaxis term is modeled by this term, divergent of cell density times gradient, the chemical substance. With plus is the attraction effect, with minus is the repulsive effect. Then the question for B, for the chemical substance, has the cell diffusion term, a degradation term, plus V, left hand side, and have a general GU term. This is a positive term, is a production term, because the living organism, when GU is positive, produce the chemical substance, yeah? And then the chemoattraction is with signal plus, with chemorepulsion with signal minus, yeah? And for the some general properties in both cases, attractive and repulsive, are the positivity for cell and chemical, U and V, and the conservation of the total cells. That means that the complete integral of the cell density is not changed in time. Then the total mass of living organism is conserved. These properties are more or less easy to prove regarding the PDE's system. But now we present a general theorem, a theorem normally is proved. This type of theorem is proved by Amann and collaborators and some other researchers following the ideas of Amann school, that for the general system with attractive or repulsive chemotaxis, even with reaction term for the U equation and other reaction term, general reaction term for the V equations, and with the hypothesis of regularity for the reaction terms, the positivity for the reaction term means that the reaction term in U must be positive when U is zero, or the reaction term in V must be positive when V is zero. And also giving initial conditions for U and V, and for instance, the natural or the boundary conditions. And then there are two types of results: the local in time existence and uniqueness of classical solutions, during a certain maximum time t max. Local, and also other type of result is the extensibility. That means that this local time is global when, sorry, is local, is really local when the density of the chemical blow up, the Lin sub is plus infinity blow up, either in cell or in chemical, in certain norm, L infinity for a cell, W1Q for the chemical signal. Now some works about the chemoattraction linear production problem. This is the Killer-Segel, the more classical Killer-Segel problem. Sorry. Plus here in the chemotaxis system for the attraction and linear production. The production is U in the right hand side of the V equations. Then in this problem has a dissipativity property. That means that there is an energy, this energy is potential for U, is a capital F U, is a H1 norm for V, gradient V square plus V square, but it appears a negative part in this energy, quadratic negative part, minus integral UV. And in fact, this quadratic negative energy is responsible to produce sometimes blow up in this type of problem. This negative part arises combining the chemotaxis and production term. Okay, in fact, this energy is obtained multiplying the U equation times F prime U minus V. F prime U is logarithm U, and multiplying the V equation times time derivative V. And then these combinations produce this type of energy. Then with this energy, globally expected, and many words in the last 20 years or little more for some a great variety of authors, there are many words proving either blow up or no blow up. For instance, no blow up in 1D domain and blow up in two dimensional and three dimensional domain, depending on the quantity of the total mass in organisms and the chemotaxis coefficient. More or less, when these quantities are large, then blow up arise. Okay. Then this problem is rather difficult to analyze. Now we pass to the repulsion problem with potential production. Yeah, and then in this case, we have the minus in the chemotaxis term because it's repulsive, and the production is U power P. For instance, P equal to 1 is the linear production term. The superlinear is P between 1 and 2, is the superlinear term. The P equal to 2 is the quadratic case. And we will see that P greater than 2 is, in fact, an open problem. It's not clear if when a production term with power greater than 2 is not clear if this problem has well posed. Yeah. Well, then we will analyze the linear case and the superlinear case, maximum quadratic case. Yeah. We will study this problem in order to introduce the optimal control problem related to this type of problem, yeah? But before that, this problem has the positivity properties, the conservation properties is the same as before, but there is a dissipative energy, but this energy is a more regular energy, because in this case, the idea is that the chemo repulsion and the production like are two effects difference with different properties, then there is a combinations multiplying by test function F prime U logarithm U, for instance, in the linear case, or U P minus one in the nonlinear production in the U equation, and multiplying by minus and over P Laplacian V, the equation of V, then these combinations produce that dance chemotaxis and production cancel. Yeah. And then in this case we have a energy law, a derivative of the of a energy plus a dissipative term, positive term equal to zero, when the energy is potential in U, for instance, is the primitive or logarithm for U in the linear production, or is the LP norm LPNOR for the nonlinear productions, and with respect to V is the energy is the gradient V squared. That means that the energy depend of P of the nonlinear production, of the power of the nonlinear production, depend in the energy of U, but it's independent on the in the energy of B. And the same for the dissipative rate. Dissipative rate is depending on P because the second derivative of capital F depending on P, and the norm for dissipative part of B is a quadratic norm, is a classical L to norm square for the gradient and for the Laplacian of B. Yeah. Well, this potential energy is the primitive logarithm and the LP norm for the U case. Yeah. And then this energy produces some additional properties. For instance, produce an energy regularity. We can obtain estimates in the regular case, in the starting from the energy law. We can get weak norms, L infinity L2 and L2 H1, weak norm for gradient V, always is the same for gradient V and for and power of U, okay, and determine power of U. This produce in particular global estimate for the total concentrations of the chemical signal for the integral of in omega of B, because the, integrating the V equations, we have this energy law for the total chemical, and like the second term, the nonlinear production or the production is bounded using the energy regularity, and then this implied using the degradation term, using this plus integral V term, using this degradation term, that implies that the complete signal is bounded uniformly in time. Yeah? And starting from this previous estimate of regularity, we get this regularity, for instance, in the 3D domain, we obtain by interpolations that the U power P over 2 has a LQ regularity, in this case 10 over 3, and this implies a certain regularity for U, UP, for U. This is important because UP is the term of the production, and U appear, for instance, in the chemotaxis term, because chemotaxis term is divergent U gradient V. Then it's important the estimate for U. Yeah. The estimation for V is more or less the same, but for the gradient V. That means that gradient V is like U a power P over 2. Okay. Then V is more regular than U. That is very important in this problem. In fact, from the gradient V than and LQ regularity, that implies that the main term in the chemotaxis term, U gradient V, has a LQ regularity. Yeah. Depending on P, depending on the power of the nonlinear production. But the gradient U, this is important in order to get a compactness for U. Yeah. The gradient U. You can obtain the estimates of gradient of a cell only for P less than or equal than 2. This is the key in order that for P greater than 2 is not clear. That you have an estimate for gradient U, then if you not a compactness for U, it's not clear that this problem is well posed. Yeah. Because the regularity for gradient U, if obtained for gradient of U, P over 2, but this factor degenerate when P is greater than 2. Yeah. Then, we introduce the with space, with LP space, and with a strong LQ space, with LP space is the with regularity for the power P over 2. This is the regularity obtained for you. And the strong LQ space is more or less the second derivative of W has LQ regularity, and the time derivative of W have the LQ regularity, and this is the space appropriate at least for the V variable, for the chemical variables. The main result, the main analytical result, are the global in time weak solutions for the problem at the repulsion production, weak for U, strong for V, and convergent to constant state as the time goes to infinity. And for 1 and 2D domain, we have also regularity, global regularity, and unique global in time strong solutions. Yeah. This is using the regularity problem for heat equation with Newman boundary conditions, but this is using embedding sublet embedding, and this estimate are obtained only for 1D or 2D domains. The result can be seen in this paper for P1 for the linear case is the Siedler and collaborator, and for the nonlinear case, first for the quadratic and also for the superlinear case in recent paper with my collaborators. Yeah, but an open problem, and the interesting problem is that in 3D we have good solutions, but we don't know if there is blow up, either blow up or global regularity. Yeah. Well, and then this is the first part, and the second part is the definition of the optimal control problem. Yeah. And we introduce the cost functional. The cost functional is the distance between U and the decided U, V, and decided V, and a certain LP norm, L2 for V, LR for U. R is, for instance, can be two in two-dimensional or one-dimensional case, but must be greater than two, exactly 20 over 7 in 3D, in order to get the result, in order to improve the regularity of U in 3D domain, to obtain the regularity of the chemotaxis problem and the existence Lagrange multiplier, and arriving at the optimality system for this optimal control problem. Yeah, and you introduce the cost of the control F. You introduce a control F, and this control F act as a bilinear form in the V equation. We act in the chemical equation in a bilinear form. F can be more or less a rate of production or degradation of V, but we have we introduce a new term, a new nonlinear term depending of control and state, FB, acting on a subdomain or omega C, a control subdomain of the whole domain omega. Yeah, this is the control is in a closed convex LQ norm. The LQ norm must be a little more than two in two dimensional case and at least four in the C dimensional case. Yeah. And the result are existence of global optimal solutions and fair order optimality system. And the references for P1 and 2D is in COCV with my collaborator Maria Cepeda and Rodriguez Bellido, and the same for P1 to 1 and 3D, because the arguments change. I will explain quickly the difference between these two arguments. And the nonlinear production case, we have proved in 2D domains this type of result with Mejia Cepeda and Villamizar Roa. In the 2D case, the first main result is the well-Posnev of the state problem in Stone norm. For control a little more than L2, then there is a unique strong solutions, Hilbert strong solution for U, a little more for V, dependent continuously from the norm L2 plus epsilon of F. This is the first main result. The result is proved via Levi-Strauss theorem and linearizing the coupling. The problem first to solving V with U var V var truncated by the positive part. First V and second, I integrate U, the heat equation for U, when the chemotaxis is given for the U bar and the V obtaining in the first part. This is important because in this problem, this is heat equation, we regularize V, and this regularization of V is very important to control this chemotaxis term. Then the energy estimate of possible physics point is obtained via the energy dissipations, via a bootstrapping argument using the LP regularity for the Heat-Neumann problem, we conclude the regularization of the problem in 2D domains, okay? But in 3D domains, the difference is that, for instance, for control L4, we have only weak solution without uniqueness. We have only weak solution, weak for U, a strong regularity for V, but this problem has not the uniqueness. And then it's important to introduce a regularity criteria, in order to find the existence a uniqueness of the strong solutions and depending of the control. And this regularity criterion we have found is that U is a little more regular, summable. U is L20 over 5 in cube. With this additional regularity, then we have existing a uniqueness of a strong solution for the for CD domains. The proof is different. It's different than the because we have a regularizations of the problem. These regularizations is based in regularized V, the chemical, using this elliptic regularization. V minus epsilon Laplacian V equals theta. V is a regularization of theta, plus the Neumann boundary condition. Then we can obtain U theta existent via the Levi-Strauss theorem, is an independent energy estimate, passing to the limit in epsilon equal to zero, taking into account that the theta and its regularization go to zero. This four step give the existence of weak solutions, and the second part, the regularity criterion, is via a bootstrapping argument based on the regularity for Heat-Neumann problem. In fact, it's a there are many step regularizing phase. When U is more regular, then I improve the regularity of V. With this V, I improve U. With this U, I improve V, etc., etc., arriving at the system a uniqueness of strong solutions. Bien, the first result, the existence of global minimum. For that, we introduce the admissible set of the optimal problem. The hypothesis in 3D, the hypothesis that this admissible set is not empty because it's necessary here you with the regularity criteria. This hypothesis is okay, is satisfied when the control act in the whole domain and the initial chemical signal is strictly positive. But For a local distributed control, it's important to impose this hypothesis. And this hypothesis for the coefficient of difference integral in the cost function. Yeah. Then in this situation, there is this global optimal solutions via my massing sequences. Yeah. Well, the second is the existence of Lagrange multipliers. Then for this, we fix local optimal solutions. It's not necessary global solution. It's just a local optimal solution with this regularity. This is the appropriate regularity in the admissible set. And then the admissible set, we can write like affine space is the adding of the fixed local optimal solution plus a vectorial space, and the vectorial space is the same space with the zero initial data, and then in this at the end we will obtain a derivative in the direction of this with this zero initial data for the direction of the optimality conditions. Yeah. For this proof, we take two steps. One step is proving that this physics local minimum has a regular point. That means that for any data L2, L2, the linearized problem around this local minimum, this is the linearized problem with the boundary condition and the zero initial condition, has a solution in the admissible set. Yeah, this is the first part. For this is a linear problem, and the more important case is the regularity of the local optimum. And the second step is the system of Lagrange multiplier. But these Lagrange multipliers are very good solutions. It's a very good solution because it belongs only to L2, L3 prime spaces. Is a very good solution of this variational problem, obtaining the deriving the problem. And with this optimality condition for the convex of the control, the direction of the convex is capital F minus F hat F. And the first part is the system of very weak Lagrange multiplier. And the second part is the regularity. We prove the regularity of the Lagrange multiplier. And this regularity has two steps. The first step is this, to prove the system of a strong solution of the problem satisfied in a very weak form for the Lagrange multiplier. And the second step is proving the uniqueness of very weak solution, the Lagrange multiplier, and a strong solution proved in step one. And then the Lagrange multiplier logically is the unique strong solution proved in step one. And then we prove the regularity of the Lagrange multiplier. Then the conclusion is the coupled forward backward optimality system UV lambda eta, UV state, lambda eta adjunct state, and with the optimality condition for the minimum. Yeah. And in order to finish my presentations, some words about the nonlinear production term, yeah, the nonlinear with p between 1 and 2, yeah. Then again, chemotaxis and production cancel, yeah, and we have a energy law, time derivative of energy, the same energy as before, depending on p for u and L2 nor for gradient v, and the dissipation term is the same as before, but now a new term appears depending on the control term, or the bilinear control term, depending on FV Laplacian V, because in the V equation we multiply by minus Laplacian V to obtain the energy law. Then the main problem is to bound the integral V squared, because in the energy we control the gradient V, but we have no control on V, and V depending on a P production term. Yeah. In fact, the integral of V squared, this if we add this term to the gradient V squared, then we have a HU1 norm for V. This depends of LP norm is UP squared. And then in the energy of U, I have integral UP, but no UP squared. Then it's not possible directly to control this term square by this term without square. Then in here is a technical result using the Galgero-Nirenberg inequality. At the end, we control this potential term, integral UP square, by the dissipative term, plus with epsilon, with a small parameter, plus other term depending just on the L1 U norm, and this is controlled because we have a conservation of the L U norm for the cells. Okay, and well, this is technical, but we can reproduce the same result in this term. The conclusion is we have the bilinear control introduced. A nonlinear regular term in the semiotaxis PD model. And then it's not possible to use the classical result of a Mangan argument. And then it's necessary to change of argument because the control is just, has only an LP regularity. Yeah. And then a regularity criterion must be deduced in the 3D domains. And we obtain a system of global optimal solutions, a system of very weak Lagrange multiplier, and regularity of the Lagrange multiplier, concluding that the optimality regularity. Yeah. The work in progress. We have I have in this moment two work in progress in this direction. The first one is for chemoattraction, not chemorepulsion, chemoattraction plus production term, like Killer-Segel, for instance, but with a logistic reaction term for U. Then in this case, the chemotaxis and the production has a feedback effect, has no contrary effect. And but the reaction term want to control the blow up, the possible blow up than you. These three effects, I think that we can reproduce with a control E also distributed in the V equation in order to obtain the result for the optimal control problem. And the same for the chemoattraction with consumption. Now, cells go to high concentration of V, but the cell consume chemical. Then in this case, it also has a balance that produces an energy dissipation, but it's more technical, it's a more complex energy than before. Well, we are working in that. And finally, the reference is on the first reference for the analytical results. The first two, the second and the third are, in fact, are numerical results, but previously we have analyzed the problem. And this is the three papers that whose result I have presented in this talk. Okay. Then we finish here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Francisco, for excellent talk. Any question, comments, please open the microphone or write in the chat. Francisco, I have a question. In the first problem, can you consider F and G, negative F and G for some U and V? U and V, for example, negatives also?
No, no, no. F has no sign. F, the linear control, here, the linear control have no signs. This control, you can control adding chemical the signal or subtracting chemical signal. Yeah, F had not a sign. This is this is just the reason why we impose a bilinear control. Because if you impose a second right-hand side control, for instance, F, only F, then F must be positive. Or if in certain area is negative, maybe it's small, in order that, because this control cannot drive the V equation to negative for V. But when you impose the linear control, then you can add or subtract a signal in order to control the problem.
Other question: in this functional, is possible to consider different subdomain instead omega for each variable?
This is a good question, because for instance, you have a subdomain for control, no? You have a subdomain omega control, omega C. But in the three-dimensional case, it's important to measure the different of the cell and the size cell in the whole domain, because this is the reason why I get the regularity criteria for the cell necessary to regularize the system associated to the optimal control problem. Then for V, no. For V, it's possible to measure just in an observation subdomain, not necessarily the whole domain, but for U, it's necessary. Yeah? But in two-dimensional case, no, because in two-dimensional case, the regularity, the weak regularity for the system is just sufficient to give regular unique strong solution for this system. But in the three-dimensional case, it's necessary to measure in the whole domain. This is a good point.
I have one question. Chamo tax, PDE, global estimate. Okay, from integral V, slide, one moment.
Slide, this?
Global in time estimate.
For instance, this global...
Yes. The last inequality.
This?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, I don't know.
This is due to the energy estimate, because for instance, if P is equal to one, then it's directly from the conservation of U. Yeah? For the linear production, the integral of U is equal to the integral of the initial cell density. Yeah, but with P is greater than one, then this LP norm is estimate global in time, imposing this regularity. U, P over two is anything to L2. This implies that U power P than L1 is L infinity in time. And this is bounded using the energy estimates.
Okay.
Like you have a reaction, boundary reaction term, like you have these degradations, for me, then this degradation control the possible effect of the right-hand side term in order to control the complete chemical signal. Yeah.
Okay.
You have a global in time. This is very important in order to get global in time regularity at infinite time, and also in order to prove that this type of model converts to the constant state when the time goes to infinity. The problem of this chemorepulsion production system are not the long time behavior. The long time behavior goes to the constant state. The important case here is to study the transient problem, no? From zero to capital T, for instance. In 3D, it's not clear if you have a unique regular solution, for instance.
Thank you again, Francisco.
Okay, you're welcome. Thank you again. And thank you for your invitations. Thank you.